Hi, this is Wasim. Welcome to my channel, where today I will discuss six strategies to migrate one's applications and systems to the cloud. Before I begin, please ensure to subscribe to this channel, where I regularly discuss topics on digitalization and technology that may be of interest to technology executives such as CIOs, CTOs, and technical architects and others. In today's episode, I'll cover the six fundamental migration strategies that organizations have at their disposal when migrating to the cloud. These strategies are based on Gartner's research and also on the work that Amazon has done in helping their customers to migrate to the cloud. Both Gartner and Amazon discuss these extensively on their blogs and websites as well. As a technology executive, if you are still in the early phases of your cloud migration journey, a review of these strategies can help you in developing the right mental models that in turn can guide you to develop your own digital transformation journey. So let's get started. One of the key phases that every organization goes through when migrating its legacy systems to the cloud is that of a discovery process. In this phase, the organization essentially takes a detailed inventory of its systems and then decides one by one on the effort and cost required to do the migration. This step is usually done by keeping the overall business case and objectives of the migration in perspective. For each of the applications and systems in its inventory, the organization may decide on a specific migration strategy or approach. We will discuss those strategies next. The first strategy is that of rehosting. This is also referred to as lift and shift and involves migrating system or application as is to the new cloud environment. The focus is to make as few changes to the underlying system as possible. During the discovery process of the migration planning exercise, systems that qualify for such a migration are usually considered quick wins as they can be cost and effort. However, as the application system usually involves a simple lift and shift, such a system isn't expected to utilize the cloud native features and thus isn't optimized to run in a cloud environment. Thus, depending on the system, it may even be more expensive to run the new migrated system on the cloud. These types of issues should be considered before categorizing a system for such type of migration. Refactoring is the second migration strategy and falls on the other extreme of the migration effort because it requires a complete change and re-engineering of the system or application logic to fully make use of all the cloud features. When complete, however, this application is fully optimized to utilize cloud-native features. So even though the cost and effort required for this migration can be quite high, in the long run, this approach can be efficient and cost-effective because the application is re-engineered to make use of the cloud-native features. A typical example of refactoring is changing a mainframe-based monolithic application from its current form to a microservices-based architecture. When categorizing an application as refactoring, the business should perform a detailed business case analysis to justify the investment of the cost, effort, and a potential business impact, and also to ensure that other alternatives are considered as well. Replatforming is the third type of migration strategy, and this type of migration is similar to rehosting, but requires few changes to the application. Amazon's AWS team refers to this approach as lift, tinker, and shift. Even though this approach closely resembles that of rehosting, it's categorized differently simply because it requires some changes. For example, in doing such migrations, an organization may plug its application to a new database system that's on the cloud, or change its web server from a proprietary version such as WebLogic to Apache Tomcat, which is an open source based web server. So for planning purposes, it's important to categorize it as such. Obviously, if a system or application is going to be changed to make even slight changes, it may need to be put through more thorough retesting processes. The fourth strategy is that of repurchasing. This migration strategy entails essentially switching the legacy application in favor of a new but similar application on the cloud. Migrating to a SaaS-based system would be an example of such a migration where an organization may decide to migrate from its legacy financial system to a SaaS-based financial ERP system. The fifth strategy is about retiring systems and applications that an organization no longer needs. During the discovery process, an organization may find applications as part of its inventory that are no longer actively used or have limited use. In such cases, those types of applications may be considered for retirement, and users of those systems, if any, can be provided other alternatives. The final strategy is that of retaining. In some cases, the organization may decide not to touch certain applications and systems and to postpone their migration for later in the future. This may be either that the applications are too critical to be touched at that point in time or require a more thorough business case analysis. Either way, it's normal for organizations to not touch some applications and systems during their cloud migration efforts. In some cases, however, such as a data center migration, organizations may not have a choice, and in those cases, they'll have to consider one of the earlier described strategies. To conclude, although the strategies that I've covered address most of the common cloud migration scenarios, as a technology executive, you can devise other categories based on your specific business needs. Defining these migration categories and their criteria up front can be a major and helpful step to aid in the migration of your legacy systems to the cloud. Hope this session was useful. Again, to ensure that you don't miss any future episodes, do subscribe to this channel.